How's it going, everybody? Aloha and welcome to Cover 2 Overtime. I'm Rob DeMello. Joining me, the Hawaii Prep World's Billy Hall, and we got the living legend, Rich Miano, over here. Guys, we just had Cover 2 Hawaii High School Football Weekly, which is every Thursday at 9:30 p.m. right here on KHON2. And, of course, the marquee matchup, the Built for Tough matchup, was Punahou against Kamehameha, because we're talking playoffs in the ILH. The winner advances to take on St. Louis next week in a winner-take-all for the ILH championship. Now, we saw this game a couple of weeks ago, Punahou winning 30-14, but Kamehameha had the buff and blue in this one. It was a tie game at halftime. They were only down by 6 in the fourth quarter, but Punahou able to pull that one out. If Kamehameha were to win this game tomorrow, who must stand out? Who's the MVP of this game for the Warriors?
You know, that's a really good question. We know with Kamehameha, it's going to start on defense. It's going to start with Kupono Blake there on the defensive line, Tiger Peterson, Hoku Arias, linebackers. They're going to have to slow down Punahou a little bit. Punahou scored 28 points in the game. Kamehameha's got a good defense, and their defense has kept them in games this season against Punahou, against St. Louis. It's been competitive in the first half. But second half is where it's got them. And then for them to have more success in the second half, they're going to have to do something on offense. So whether it's one of those running backs, Reno Bush, Alex Arau, one of those guys, a quarterback stepping up, somebody's going to have to make a play on offense at some point in this game for Kamehameha to have a chance to keep its season going.
And that's been the bugaboo for the Warriors this year. Their defense pretty much coming out every single week, and the offense just not being able to capitalize on what the defense provides them in the first half. On the other side, the Buff and Blue, in order for them to pick up a second consecutive win over Kamehameha, and which would be an 11th in 12 attempts,
games, I think, yeah. Wow.
Who stands out for the Buffs?
Well, I'm going to first talk about Punahou has a little bit more balance. When I talk about balance, I'm talking about Hugh Brady to Tamatoa Faletea. But not only that, is Vincent Terrell or Kaufusi, the two running backs, are phenomenally talented and gifted. So I think offensively, Punahou has some weapons. But I'm going to talk about the defense, because Maris Liufau, Kalana Makala, you talk about guys like Alakai Gilman, Maninoa Tufono, Trent Shiraki. I mean, they're loaded defensively. They don't have a great front three, but that back end is going to make enough plays to solidify the fact that defense wins championships.
And hearing you guys talk about these two teams, they're studs this football game, so be sure to check it out at Aloha Stadium tomorrow. I believe kickoff is at 6 p.m. It's an earlier start than most ILH matchups, so get down there to Halava. The OIA now, Division II playoffs get started this weekend, and this is big because not only does a win take you into the OIA championship the following week, but it also gives you tickets into the state tournament. So these are huge games. You have Pearl City taking on Roosevelt, Kaimuki against Kaiser. What jumps off out of the sheet as far as why football fans need to be interested in these games?
Well, I think first off, you just look at all four of these teams have some cool stories this year. I think you start with Kaimuki, who's had a couple of excruciating losses. They've gotten to this point in the semifinals before with a chance to get to the state tournament and lost. But they go through the thing undefeated. They're really good. You've got Roosevelt having one of their best years in a long time, 8-2 overall, I believe. You got Pearl City. You know, they've taken it on the chin a couple times the last couple of weeks, but you're one win away from the playoffs. And then Kaiser. I mean, let's give Kaiser some credit here to make the playoffs this year. Remember, they only played one game last year. You know, we know about all the problems they had out there, but to come back, get that 4 seed, and to get into the playoffs, this is a good opportunity for them.
You're a huge advocate for the system that we have in Hawaii now with Open Division, Division I, Division II, and it was created for this. I mean, this is the living example of why this is great, right? Is the stories that Billy just provided us at the Division II level. It's been fantastic, and these games are going to be great, right?
Yeah, and start with Kaiser, because that is almost a Cinderella story. What they've done this year, Tim Seaman, Brian Amadova, Richard Torres, all those coaches, Mark Gardner, have done a phenomenal job. The kids believe in each other, and they're playing really well. That being said, they're the fourth seed for a reason. I think also give props to Robin Kami. I think he's done a great job with Pearl City. They don't have great athletes, but they play together and they play well. But I'm going to jump all the way. I think Roosevelt's had a great season as well. But I'm going to jump all the way up to Kamuki, because when you have 25 guys on your team and you have 5 guys pulled up from the JV and you're going both ways and you have 1 day of practice on offense, 1 day on defense, and then you talk about a quarterback that threw for over 400 yards against Kaiser earlier in the season, and you see the potential that they have, and then Sama Pa'ama. That's just a difference maker. He's just a wrecking crew. He may be the best player in the state that most people are starting to recognize, but he makes a difference both offensively and defensively. I think Kaimuki wins the whole thing, but I think it'll be exciting.
Yeah, it really sets up to be, and what also sets up to be exciting in our bonus topic, University of Hawai'i football, the Rainbow Warriors can lock up bowl eligibility with a win over Nevada on Saturday. It would also keep them in first place in the West Division standings. It would guarantee a winning regular season for the first time since this guy was coaching with them in 2010. This is a huge game. How does Hawai'i win this one? And we've seen the three-man rush, the eight-man box that defense has been throwing at them. And it's only, I feel like it's only fitting that Timmy Chang is on the other side of the sideline, because that's when Hawai'i fans first saw defenses try to attack Hawai'i in this way. How does Hawai'i beat Nevada and have that goodie bag of goodness happen to them after that game?
Yeah, they're probably going through practice this week, trying to throw in a couple of wrinkles, trying to figure out something to do. I'm not going to predict this game because I believe last week I predicted Hawai'i was going to beat BYU.
I wasn't
going to take myself
out. Nobody's listening to you anyway.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm not going to predict this game. But just, you talked about Timmy Chang, and right before we did this, I just decided to go look up some of his high school stats. You realize he threw 64 touchdown passes his senior year of high school.
Crazy.
64. Chevin Cordero was the player of the year last year and threw 29 touchdown passes. He had 64. It'll be good to see Timmy back.
Yeah, and because Timmy is in this game as a tight ends coach for Nevada, I put in some old highlights of Timmy that I was going to show on the news. And his ball, I mean, the way he threw a football is something that, I mean, that didn't come around very often. He just had the touch. You got to see it up close and personal. But back to Hawai'i, Nevada, how does this happen?
Well, I think Hawai'i has to be more physical on both the offensive and the defensive lines. But I also think that Hawai'i has to take the ball away defensively. Right now, Hawai'i only has 4 INTs and 1 fumble recovery. That's 129th in the nation out of 130 teams. They're going against an opportunistic defense that actually has one of the leaders in the nation taking the ball away in terms of fumble recoveries. They have 6 interceptions. And I think Hawai'i is going to have to do some things with the quarterback in terms of running the football and taking what the defense gives them underneath. When you have 8 people dropping back, that's 3 deep, and that's 5 underneath, and a 3-man pass rush, just take the underneath stuff. Mm-hmm. Make somebody miss. If you get the ball in the hands of John Ursua, Cedric Bird, they're going to make somebody miss, and they'll turn those 5 or 6 yard gains into 14, 15, 16 yard gains. And Hawaii's going to have to start fast. They've been successful when they've started fast. They cannot fall behind in this football game.
It should be a lot of fun Saturday night at Aloha Stadium. It will be on Spectrum Sports. We'll be there for Spectrum Sports in that pay-per-view broadcast. You will be there covering it for
the Star Advertiser. I'll be in the press box.
And you also have your other guys at the Hawai'i Prep World covering high school football, and you have your laptop, and it's going to be bonkers for you, right?
It's just another Saturday.
Busy day.
Well, if you need to get set up for this weekend in Hawai'i high school football, be sure to catch Cover 2 On Demand at KHON2.com. And remember, it's every Thursday night, 9:30, right here on KHON2. For Billy Hall, for Rich Miano, I'm Rob DeMello. Thanks for watching, everybody. Aloha.